All right. This is going to be chapter 16, 100%. I'm going to skip over 15 because, well, both of my runs were bad. And since I'm going to redo 14 anyway, I decided I'll just do 15 as well. Anyway, so we're going to start by firing this cannon, turn to this gate, firing that part, or that wall, whatever. We're going to collect the storage scroll here. Take out these enemies. Now we'll enter over here. There's going to be a few enemies. But more importantly, a soul gem that happens to be Hex's. Oops. Alright, so there's going to be more enemies over here. Quite a few more enemies over here. I'm gonna make a hard take. Cadaverous Crypt is not a bad chapter. Not a great chapter, but it's not a... I kinda like it. It's a cool idea, I think. And the chapter itself plays out well. Anyway, so fun block pushing section. Hopefully I don't soft lock. It's not really a soft lock, but it's a weird glitch where you have to like constantly spam the home menu. Oop, wrong way. Yeah, clearly I'm not experienced in this chapter since I've known this speedrun longer ever since we've like actually just skipped the whole chapter. Anyway, by that I mean zoo clipping, which we're not going to be doing. Oh crap, that's my fault. That's also my fault. Oh, come on. Yeah, I hate that one. There's one key left. You think you can just get off loose, but now you have to like start over the animation. That's really annoying. Alright, there's going to be more enemies over here. And trigger happy soul gem. Alright. I'm gonna push this cannon. And soon we're actually gonna pull out a fan favorite Skylander. That's gonna be Drobot. And this is the only chapter he's used in this speedrun. In fact, I think this is the only time we ever use him in Spyro's Adventure. We never use him in any other IL, but we're going to use him for most of this chapter for now. One, he can do that, so he can take out the zombies. While we do that, we're going to push this button. It's going to overlay cutscenes. So, yeah, we kind of have to do that, but... it's a nice optimization you can make to push the button. Okay, so here's something special. Enemy count in the elemental gates, both earth and tech, do not count towards the full enemy count that you need to get. This is the only chapter I know this exists in. I don't know why, but I know that from experience. Come on. Anyway, I have to get this one right here. Oh, come on. Yeah, I was supposed to get this one. Of course, these enemies still get in your way. There's going to be a chest here. It's also in the undead, the Earth Gate, I believe. But we're going to get it here. If you start hitting an enemy, I'd kill it just in case, like, all of a sudden that screws up the enemy ghoul. Anyway, this is what I believe to be the fastest pattern of collecting these skulls, but I'm probably wrong. All right. So now we're gonna click the hat. Oh, careful, guys. Shh. I have to watch over my siblings right now. Alright. Why did I stop? Alright, so we're gonna enter over here, take out more enemies. I suggest getting some crit on your Drobot. I almost called him Ghost Rister. But not required. I haven't done much work on my Drobot. I have some speed though, since I used him in Giants. Alright, so we're gonna wait for the player 1 and player 2 symbols to appear below our Skylanders, and then we can take bash off. I did that too early. I tried to anticipate it. There we go. Well, oops. Come on. Alright, so now we're gonna go here, and we're just gonna exit the cave. And I'll take out this enemy, because he's just annoying. Yeah, these guys are placed in the worst spots. Come on. Yeah, there's three of them that get in your way. That is three too many. Fun fact, in the HD version of the game, when you complete the maze, a chest spawns with this hat. But not in the Wii version. So, in the Wii version, the chest is just in the elemental gate. Anyway, now we get to progress. The other reason we use Drovot, although Drovot's not very fast, I mean, he's pretty fast, but not, like, super fast. He has the second highest DPS in the game, but also, again, burns up zombies, has long range, which we actually do need, briefly. There's also just a lot of block pushing, so we don't need to do too much movement. And also the tech gate. So he just has so many good uses for this chapter in 100% that we're gonna abuse that. Ooh, come on. Get in. This movement is a little tricky though. Anyway, legendary treasure is one of my favorite legendary treasures just because I actually remember this one. Did it just hit something? What the heck? I think it just hit some items, but I'm not sure. Anyway, this will open up when you take out all three, so I know I took one out even though he was off screen. Anyway, so you'll see the enemies to the right. Oh, I wasn't supposed to do that. Alright, well, I'll take them out. I'll do that. Yeah, I'm supposed to push this cannon. So we have a lot of enemies here. Okay, we don't really want to die, so I'm just gonna... Alright, we're gonna push the cannon over here and get this chest. This is the last chest. We got all the enemies over there by the right, that's nice. Don't think you can get them with stealth off. I mean, there might be like a combo attack you can get with if you have the combo attacks, which you don't really want. Now we're gonna fire this cannon, and there's gonna be a lot of zombies here. Oh, what am I doing? Okay, that was stupid. Cannons are annoying. You can quote me on that if you want. It's like a block, but you have to hit the C button as well. Alright, do not miss these enemies, because, like, you can probably... Because if you miss one, and then you shut this gate on you, that's bad. I mean, you can't really kill the enemies. I mean, I don't know, maybe you could Z attack with Flameslinger as a backup. Anyway, we're gonna set up a warp there so that we can finish the chapter later. It's actually a much longer IL than I anticipated. I think it'll probably go sub 10 minutes, or at least it should be able to, even if this doesn't. It's been an alright IL, definitely beatable. Alright, hopefully we got everything. And remember to spam C for the cutscene. And then we're gonna warp with Ghost Roaster so that we can take this boss out, or this battle again, as quickly as possible. Alright. And should be good. We are indeed. Alright, I think that's barely sub 10 minutes. And we got the enemy goal. So as I said, elemental gate enemies don't count. And yeah, this is chapter 16. Kind of a sloppy one, but it's kind of fun. I do enjoy it. And also, yes, chapter 15, I'll do that one eventually. I've done it, and I've done it twice. Both runs were terrible, and you know what? I don't really want to submit a terrible run. That's just me. I should not have submitted that chapter 14 one I did, by the way. Especially because on the same day, Bensel found some really cool strats. There's a Ghost Rooster clip you can do that's actually much easier than I thought. And there's also, like, bash strats in it. That's cool. But anyway, I digress. That's chapter 16. Pretty cool one. Thanks for watching.